What's going on, guys? Above Average here with another video. Like I said, I'm not very consistent. I'm usually pretty busy. And then when I do get out to do it, I don't usually bring the camera, but I got a nice rat video I made up. I'm doing some muskrat trapping. And we got like 108 or something on the year. I'm pulling some traps here. I might go set a few more before the ice comes. But I made this video. Hopefully you guys get something out of it. Just some things I do when I'm trapping. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy it. I'll try and make a few more videos throughout the year, but just busy working and stuff, and hauling a camera around is kind of a pain in the ass. So I did just pick up live scope last night for ice fishing, so hopefully you guys get to see that this winter. But as of right now, here's a rat trapping video, and hopefully you enjoy.
You don't want to dirty it all up, because then you won't be able to see for your remake. But we got a muskrat run going into this here. Usually I set colony traps. I ran out of colony traps yesterday, so I just set a 110 on here. It's a little deep, and after I pulled that rat out of there, it's kind of hard to see. So you kind of got to go by feel. It's a tough luck of muskrat trapping. I just got this here to market. But yeah, you just got to find these runs. I'll show you on a different set, but we did pick up a rat here.
As you can see on our colony set, they just keep piling in. There's a bank den here with a really big run. Yesterday in the sunlight, you could see it a lot better. It's kind of deep. It's heavily used, so it's kind of hard to set. Kind of just go by feel, like you're noodling for catfish, if you've ever done that, which I haven't. So on this pond at this golf course, I just rode the edge and was looking for runs and stuff. And this isn't like a major run, but you can see how it's like kind of sandy all over. And there's a pile of sand right here where it's kind of kicked out. There's a hole in there where he's bedding or denning in there where his hut is or where he's living. It's not like a lot of them where it's like a big run, but it was enough to put a 110 in there, which is perfect for these 110s, just these little ones. And a lot of them bigger ones, I like to run a colony. That way you can catch more at once and it's not blocking it off. But we got us a rat here, and we'll reset it and see if there is more. So there's a pond on that side over there with this big culvert that comes through into this pond. And all this grass is long. And you can see, I don't know if you guys can see, there's a trail that runs right through here like this. That's the trail that they're gonna take. I don't know, can you see that? The trail right there. And that's what they use. I actually set this yesterday, and within, I don't know, half hour, there's actually one swimming alive in there. It's pretty cool. And just shows you how fast they do it. So what you do is clean this all out. Make sure your trap is in good working order. This is a colony trap. It's just a cage, and the two doors flip in. So after they swim in, like, whoop, then they're trapped in there because the door doesn't flip back open. So great effective way to help out these golf courses. You gotta make sure that that's underwater, otherwise what they'll do is they'll stick their nose up and they won't be dead when you get here. So I know sometimes what you can do is if it's not down far enough, you can take your boot and kind of kick the ground, that way it goes down just a little bit more. So right here's another one of them 110 sets like earlier, just into a little hole, nothing in that one, but you can see how the sand is kicked out all the way out to here. It's a pretty good run going into this bank den, and you can see he's bringing his little food in, and we got us a rat. Can't ask for much more than that. Get that bad boy right back in there, just like so, and move along. I don't know if you can see it, you can see right here, it's kind of, it's not pure sand, but I can see the sand over there is pushed up. There's sand out there, and I can see where the grass or the feet is where they're going in. That's how I knew there was a run here. And then when I looked over, I could see a pocket where they were swimming into. So that's why I set this one. Let's see if we can't untangle this mess. So this here is a hag's rod, and what we got here. Hold on. This is the hag's rod he sells. And then he makes these, I don't know exactly what they're called, but they go in your springs. I don't even know if I have it in there right, but it works for me. You put it on your 110 like this, and then what you do is you put this on here, you slide it down, and you gotta position it so it's right in front of your run. And we got us a wrap, as you can see. Slow going today. I really thought it was gonna be better, but I guess it can't be amazing every day, right? Then what you do is you're right back in there. Greatest thing in the world right there. Greatest thing in the world. Try not to dirty the area up. Now I ran out of stands. So what I've been doing is I just take two rebar stakes like this, and then where the rivets are on the trap, I set it on there. Seems to be working just fine. Well, last trap of the day. I got a set there. I didn't use that one, but I used this one. And a stand for it. These are the stands I prefer to use since, but I ran out of them. So this goes in here like this, through the top like that. And then the bottom goes like that. And you slide it down. And then what I like to do is I like to bring this up like that. That way it doesn't fall off the bottom when I go to set it. I got a little run here. I'm just gonna put this right down in there. Right to the very bottom. Because that's what they do, is they swim along the bottom. And tomorrow we'll have a rat net.